a report card on Maryland's effort to get its health care website fully functional again.
Governor Martin O'Malley addressed the public late this afternoon. We have live team coverage. Lead investigative reporter Jane Miller's live in the newsroom with a look at some of the concerns with the website. But first, let's head out to 11 News reporter David Collins live in Annapolis with what the governor had to say. David?
Well, the governor says the health care website in the state is working in degrees, but he could not fully answer a couple of questions the public wants to know. Is it really working, and how much of a hassle is it to use?
We've made progress by degrees. The best.
So what does that mean exactly? The governor defines it by the number of people who have been able to sign up since the last week of November.
Governor, when you say you're making progress by degrees, how close is the state to being fully functional?
Fully functional. I think the best indicator of that, David, is the graph and the additional number of enrollments. I mean, three times as many people have signed up, so we've tripled the number of people that have successfully made it through the site and enrolled.
2 weeks ago, nine issues plagued Maryland's Health Connection website, confounding IT gurus and frustrating users. The governor's new Health Exchange rescue team has resolved six of them. Screen freezes are still an obstacle. It's twofold. The site browser crashes and the enrollment button can malfunction. But the state has identified how to fix it and is tasking a way to work around those issues. The governor also reports progress on glitches that have frustrated insurance carriers.
Is it perfect? No. Is it functional? Yes.
O'Malley's update comes just 2 days after the lieutenant governor held a news conference on the same subject. Anthony Brown, who is running for governor next year, has tried to take a leadership role in implementing the president's health care program in Maryland. Brown complained about the lack of detail he got on the progress of the rollout. But he didn't say anything regarding the governor's new team, which has two of the same members at the top. Brown vowed a thorough state investigation into what went wrong. When the governor was asked about initiating an investigation, he said the focus is fixing the problem at hand. Neither Brown nor the governor detailed a plan B if the state system continues to creep toward being fully operational.
I suppose the answer to that is if we can't get them in time for January 1st enrollment, we'll get them in time for a February 1st enrollment.
But Brown offered a silver lining to those seeking to sign up for Medicaid.
If their enrollment happens after January 1st, it is retroactive, the effective date, and then the open enrollment will for all will be until the end of March.
But the sign-up will not be retroactive for those seeking a private plan, and the goal still remains 150,000 people enrolled in private plans by the end of March.